And meanwhile, the city plans to increase security for upcoming games and events. That includes tomorrow's Orioles game at Camden Yards.
Yeah, and with more on that, we're going to go now to lead investigative reporter Jane Miller. She is live in the newsroom. Jane.
Don, I have with me Gary McElhaney, former chief of the Maryland Transportation Authority Police, very much aware of what goes on in local police departments when something like this happens. What is going on? The Baltimore Police Department says it's in a state of heightened awareness. What should people expect to see?
What people will see around areas of our city that have large crowds over the next few days will be obviously an increased police presence, as well as local law enforcement coordinating with their partners on the state and federal level. Maryland's very fortunate to have a watch center, if you will, coordinated with the Joint Terrorism Task Force that pushes information out to local law enforcement. Local law enforcement feeds the watch center its information, so everybody's coordinated in their efforts.
What does what you're seeing so far suggest to you in terms of the nature of this event today?
It's still early. We're about 4 hours into this, but the indications are that this is some act of domestic terrorism, particularly because of the date that it's associated with, and this month of April that has a lot of significant dates for a lot of individuals in our country who, for whatever reason, don't particularly care for the government.
Oklahoma City being one of them, Waco, all have April dates attached to them.
Exactly, and today being Patriots Day in Boston and the significance that's attached to that day. It's tax day in our country, so yes, there's a lot of issues surrounding this date for some individuals.
Okay, Gary, thank you for coming in tonight. There's also a very big event happening tomorrow in the city of Baltimore, and that is the opening of the new University of Baltimore School of Law, and on the guest list, Supreme Court Justice Elena Kagan and Vice President Joe Biden.